Well, the coming rain may actually be very bad news, or at least certainly not welcome, for Pajaro Dunes. That area has been flooded because a sandbar blocking the Pajaro River. But today, work began to breach that block, and Action News reporter Phil Gomez was there. He's got the story on how the fix is working tonight, live from Santa Cruz.
Well, that's right, Dan. The Santa Cruz County Public Works Department couldn't break through the sandbar until conditions on their state and federal permits met criteria to drain the slough. Rain in the forecast created a safety and emergency situation, so the county can now take action. An excavator created a narrow channel that allowed water to drain from the Pajaro River and Watsonville Slough and allowed it to empty into the Monterey Bay.
The idea here is that we cut an opening that's allows for a gradual lowering of the lagoon level to address the flood hazard, but keeps the lagoon from fully evacuating, emptying out.
Neighbors in the seaside community endured swampy conditions for the last couple of weeks. High surf 2 weeks ago got trapped in the lagoon and created a sandbar that wouldn't allow the water to release. Public work crews couldn't act until conditions on state and federal permits were in place.
The high water alone in the lagoon setting is not enough. It has to be coupled with either high waves in the forecast or additional rain in the forecast, which takes it into a whole level of safety or emergency.
Residents are relieved that the waters will soon be gone because there's water at the edges of the tennis court. The parking lot at Palm Beach is underwater, and beach and shell roads are intersections you must cautiously drive through.
Well, you got to slow down anyway, so the problem is that the salt water gets on your car and underneath, it's not good for it. So over a long period of time, it's not a good deal.
It's been quite an inconvenience. The road has been flooded, and the tennis courts are starting to be flooded, that whole area in there. So yeah, it's an inconvenience.
Now, this does happen every so often where the county has to move in and create a channel so the water can drain, but usually the Pajaro River punches through it. Dan.
All right. Thank you very much, Phil. So far, no homes have been damaged because of the flooding. Crews are monitoring the site to make sure enough water is released into the Monterey Bay.